no. So what have we got here, Josh?
We've got a bit of a situation here. What do you think the problem is? Is it just cracked here, is it?
Yeah, well, when I tacked that on, it created a weak spot.
Right. So that was tacked on there. So we could just weld that back on there and put some angle on or something, or some strap there and strap that up for there. But what do you reckon?
I don't know if we need to go all the way back, do we?
Well, that's what we need to work out, is how far back do you want to go? I mean, we're talking about the length of the drawbar. How much do you want to go back now? Because that's what's giving it the bounciness.
It is, the longer the drawbar,
But you were saying you like that length because it gets you into those deep spots.
Yeah, it's good for launching a long drawbar.
So this is what we've got to look at, is how far we're going to go. And if we're going to weld it, we don't want to be cutting that weld off again. I've got a lovely tool here. A lovely little tool that I use. It's this lovely little adapter. Just puts it to the body through it.
Got it.
Weld that tack a bit here, because then that gives it two strong points, you know. One point here with that moving in and out of there is fucking, that's why it's cracking there.
You're getting old these days. Pretty old age, Josh, early old age. So that's, we call it a 19. No, no, that's a 14. Fella taught me that when you do a drill bit, it should be the same shape as your nut on here. It's the same thing, isn't it? What do you reckon?
Pretty good.
I'm just going to grind some of that galv off so the weld sticks. If you try to weld straight on the galv, it won't stick, it'll just bust off.
Thank you.
tricky.
That's so cool. There it is.
Get on you, mate. Just a few holes, a bit of slag, a bit of paint. Can't go wrong.
Time for a cup of tea then.
Better go burn some gas.
Back to work.
Come on in for a cup of tea, Bubba. The land, the milk and hay. What, we haven't put any in there really.
Oh, hey. Hey, let's go on an adventure. It's gonna be awesome.
Hey, say what's up. Say what's up. Hey, say what's up.
Say what's up.
Hey, hey, say what's up. Say what's up.
Me and Weka have come all the way from the west coast to the east coast to this big riverbed here, hoping to find some ducks. We've driven over the mountain pass and we've seen four ducks.
Two shags.
We found a lot yesterday actually, me and Jack, when we were jet boating, we found hundreds, so we might actually drive all the way back over to the west coast and just go duck shooting there, I don't know. I got new stubs put on my axle and they've made the axle too narrow and one of the tires is rubbing hard out and it's just it's getting worse. There was a couple of mil tolerance on each side, but for some reason, yeah, it's rubbing real bad now. I guess the center punch, the holes that were punched to keep the axle centered, weren't actually center. So, you know, we're gonna come up with a solution. I think we're gonna get one of these road signs and cut a bit off it and space it out. We picked up a road sign further up the road that had been broken off and we're just gonna cut some spaces off that. Good dog. There you go, I reckon we'll put some spaces in here. That should give us a little bit more gap and then have to put some washers on when we get back home.
Yeah, the wheel bearing's fucked too.
Let's go.
Yeah, mate, jump out. They dragged the pack raft out for me, mate. Bit of a mission, eh?
Yeah. It's gonna be worth it, though.
It was a heck of a mission.
Oh, bloody hell. What's happening with this one?
And you fellas?
Oh, the your epoxy. Reel that you were meant to have a good reel in a line.
Yeah.
The reel thing snapped.
The handle?
Yeah, the handle. It didn't even turn twice. It just, ting.
Oh, you tried to force it, did
you?
No! You did, didn't you?
No.
Steel no, doesn't just snap.
It was completely stuffed.
Excited, oi.
Ducks, ducks.
Patiently waiting for ducks to come in. It didn't frost the other day, or didn't frost tonight. Hopefully when we scared them off with the jet boat, they didn't just all fly off and decided never to come back here. That was only 2 days ago. We're not camping enough down here, so we're gonna move up to the top into the gorse. This is better. Get in there, Oi!
Take him out.
No chance. Oh, he's seen us.
That's how you not shoot.
Right, that was good shooting.
Just not good hitting. Great shooting, but the hitting was lacking.
Take him, take him, take those ones high.
Good shot, mate!
Smoke him, smoke him, smoke him, right there.
Boy. Yeah, boy. Ah, oh, the same one. Yeah.
Check him out. Oh, there's heaps of rough in the air too.
Oh,
nasty at the start though, wasn't it?
Oh, it was. We thought we were going to get nothing.
It took about 20 ducks to start getting.
You're
good
a bit
hits.
Slow.
Bit slow, yeah.
Bit slow. Charlie was getting more than you at the beginning.
It was the the true numbers really, eh? It was like pick the parries or take the ducks first.
True that.
And then there's more flying, it's like, and then a couple of times there where I was shooting for two ducks and I didn't even see the other three that you finally shot that. I was like, oh.
When we got up on that gorse was the go, eh? When that light come around to the bank.
Yeah, it was perfect. There was no shadow.
It was perfect. It was bloody brilliant. But no, definitely you were the man of the day. And Charlie, you were second. Yep, and I was third.
Yep. Well done.
Hell yeah. Well done. Shall we go and have some bacon and eggs, eh?
Mm, yep.
I've got a heap of eggs and bacon at home. Rams that got given yesterday, so we're just going to cut a couple of legs off, one for you and one for Wicker, eh?
Sweet.
Home and cook them up.
Holes in the skin, so when we pour the boiling water, it will melt the fat, and the fat will drain out the holes. We have some good fat to use. This duck fat's really good for roasting potatoes. Salt on here because it helps crisp the skin up.
Door on your way out, it's freezing out there.
Okay, I am going to.